This is Dr. Brad Dieter, and for those of you who are new to the channel, this is Eat to Perform, and make sure that you guys are subscribing so you can get all of our content as soon as it comes out, so you can press the subscribe button right down below. Also, if you want to make sure that you get notified to all the new content on the channel, make sure you click the notification button. So today we're going to be talking about one of the biggest topics that we get questions about all the time here at Eat to Perform. And it's no secret that a lot of Eat to Perform clients fall in the demographic that this question is actually geared towards. So the question today that we're going to be answering in this Q&A is, does menopause affect body weight? So this is one of the more nebulous questions that's out there in all of the scientific literature surrounding weight gain, weight loss, body composition, etc. And when I got this question, you know, this was not one of those areas where I was incredibly well-versed, right? A lot of my research in my career, you know, has been more in the diabetes realm, the general population realm, and a lot more of, you know, kind of the general population one. And I hadn't done a whole lot of digging into the exact effects of menopause down to the very nitty-gritty detail. So I spent several hours prepping for what's going to be probably a 3 to 4 minute video, but I wanted to give you guys the highlights and the nuggets. So when you really dive into how does menopause affect things like weight loss and body composition, here's kind of the key highlights and takeaways. Menopause itself does not appear to really increase body weight in women. It also does not appear to substantially change the body's ability to lose weight. There is some evidence that it may have a small role to play in scale weight, but that doesn't really appear to be overridden by other factors such as, you know, caloric intake, caloric expenditure, physical activity, structured exercise, and training. So it doesn't appear that it's going to really change fundamentally the thermodynamics or the body's adaptation. Now, what it does appear to do is this hormonal milieu that changes, or the hormonal environment that changes in menopause, does cause a few things that we really need to consider. One is, you're more likely to have body weight stored as body fat than lean mass when you are going through in post-menopause. This does appear to be something that we actually see quite robustly in the scientific literature. So that gives us a few things to think about. One is, we probably need to prioritize resistance training, and we need to prioritize how can we send your body signals to maintain as much lean mass as possible, right? So this is where things, you know, like women who have been training and doing aerobic exercise all of their 30s and 40s, you know, as they hit late 40s, 50s, and menopause starts to set in, it may be wise to switch to more structured weightlifting and more structured resistance training types of exercise. Now, there also does appear to be a change in overall metabolism towards what we would say increases cardiovascular risk profile, right? So things like cholesterol starts to increase a little bit as hormones change, triglycerides start to increase a little bit. And so those are also things you need to consider. So the big answer to this question is there are changes in hormones that change how your body composition will change. But we should gear things more towards pretty much trying to offset some of those things. But it doesn't really appear to have substantial effects on the actual scale weight. So the scale weight is still something that we can adjust based on the levels of controls that we know. And we have a lot of data in our database at this point. You know, we're sitting at probably about 40 million data points as of this video. And I would say probably 30% of those data points are from women who fall under this purview. So we can really start to understand how much is this affecting people. And from the scientific literature and our real world applied data, we're seeing those things kind of line up. One other thing I will mention before we close on this Q&A is why resistance training is also very important in postmenopausal or menopausal women is the fact that bone mineral density is something that does appear to decrease substantially during and after menopause. And so if you can use some of the concepts of progressive overload, of resistance training, of vertical loading, of stressing the skeletal structure by engaging in resistance training and things like that, you're also going to slow the osteoporosis or the loss of bone tissue. So you can actually have more bone integrity over time as you start to age. So That is the answer to the question of, does menopause affect weight loss in women? Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure that you do subscribe to the channel because there's going to be more content coming out a lot as we get ready for the new year. You guys know what's coming into the new year because I am wearing two jackets inside. That's how cold it is. Anyway, I'm Dr. Brad Dieter. Thank you guys for tuning in. Make sure you subscribe and hit the notification button and share these videos with people who you think need the real truth about nutrition, exercise, dieting, weight loss, health, longevity, you name it. We'll see you guys later. Take care.